I'm going to use this application from the MSDN sample site to demonstrate how to deploy a managed code application to Lync Server. The key bits you need to know you can see right here. I'll walk through each of these items in the next few minutes. On the sample application page, click the button here to download the code. Extract the files and launch Visual Studio 2012. I'm going to make a few changes to the project. Add a reference to serveragent.dll, which you get as part of the Lync Server SDK. Edit the manifest files to make sure that the URI is appropriate. I'll give both manifest files the same URI. Configure the project so that it's built as a 64-bit application. Build the application, then go to the output folder and grab the executable and the two manifest files, which I'll copy to the Lync front-end server. Here's my front-end server, which is a virtual machine and part of the test drive topology, available as a free download from the Microsoft Download Center. On the front-end server, first of all, take a look at the membership of RTC Server Applications, which is a local group on this computer. I'm signed in as a Contoso domain administrator, and you can see that I'm a member of this group. See here, I've copied the output files from the sample application to the folder Lync Server, Server Core. This is not a requirement, but it's a sensible choice because so many of the other applications are placed here. I'll use the Lync Server Management Shell to register the application with the commandlet new CS Server Application. In a second, I'll show you the documentation for this command so you can look all this up later. The parameters I enter specify the application is not critical, will not run as a top priority, specify the application identity, and that the app is enabled. Then I'm prompted for the URI, and I must be careful that the URI I enter here matches the URI listed in the manifest, or the application will not register. And here's the help topic for the commandlet I just used. All the Lync Server commandlets are documented in the TechNet library. Now I'll launch the app. In File Explorer, I right-click the .exe file and specify that it run using admin privileges. The SIPSnoop sample application opens on the desktop, and I'll click the Connect button, and you can see the text tells us it connects to the server. Now, SIPSnoop's a great application I'll not try to demonstrate right now. I just want to do a few things on the server topology, just enough to get SIPSnoop to do a little work so you can see for yourselves that it's properly registered and working. To begin with, notice the left pane and all the zeros in session statistics. That will change. What I'll do to accomplish this is open the Lync client here on the front end and send an IM to another user. And quickly here the recording transitions to the terminal server computer where I'll answer the IM. Back on the front end server, you can see some changes to session statistics and notice, for example, that the by counter changes when I close the conversation window. All that just to demonstrate that the application is registered and running. So that's how to register a managed code application on Lync Server 2013. Stay tuned for another video demonstrating the SIPSnoop sample itself. Finally, if you have questions, I invite you to take advantage of the Server SDK forum on MSDN. We keep a pretty close eye on messages posted there and do our best to provide answers to your questions.